A familiar sight, the beach at Bloberg. Once again, the scene for an exciting slalom board sailing contest. 80 competitors, including 12 women, among them 20 world-rated internationals. The beach is alive, the wind is up, and preparations are underway. Getting ready for the big event, the defending champion and number one seed, Ono Tellier.
I think my chances are not bad. My wave riding was okay. I don't know, in the overall, like, to have an overall rank, it's going to be really hard because everybody's really good. Like, a lot of South Africans got much better. I heard they have new slalom boards. They have much better slalom boards than last year. I've seen them too. So it's going to be harder than last year, that's for sure.
Of the 12 women competitors, 4 were world-ranked sailors, pitting their skills against 8 highly rated South Africans. Top seed, Dana Dawes.
I've competed against most of the international girls that are here, and my chances with them, I say, are pretty good. But I have no idea how the local girls here sail, and I was really impressed with their wave sailing. They could be really, really tough competition for slalom.
It's going to be interesting just to see the guys sailing. I'm really looking forward to the overseas guys. I think last year we learnt a lot and we were really a long way behind. I think we still are a little bit behind, but I think this year it's going to be a little different. I think our guys are in with more of a chance, but obviously the guys off the World Cup are a lot better than we are, and their experience will show.
I'm number 2, and I think I have a good chance though against Ono and everyone else. I've been doing a lot of slalom sailing, a lot more than I have wave riding, and I feel pretty good and pretty confident. Also, the system we're using is really good.
The system is intended to ensure that the best competitor wins through skill, good fortune, and quality equipment alone, and not as a result of procedural devices or legalistic argument. Terry Weiner explains.
Golf GTI is a slalom event. Slalom is an out-and-out race from a beach start, or at times you can run from a water start. We're using the beach start here. Round 2 marks in a figure of 8, finishing up on the beach again. What we do is we run 8 in a heat, 4 advance into the next heat. And so we go on until we have a final with 8 people. In the world system that's being run at the moment, as soon as you've lost 2 heats, you're out of the contest. Here, you can go on and on, and you've got a chance, even if you have a bad first round and a fairly bad second round, you can get back into it and get right up into the top points again, and of course the money.
Prize money totaled 20,000 rand. 40 of the 80 competitors share 16,500, and the winner gets 3,500 rand. Racing into the surf for the exciting eliminating rounds, the cream of world board sailors show us that they can do it. Conditions couldn't have been better as the competitors took to the surf. The pumping southeaster at times reaching 45 knots. set the foundation for some exciting speed slalom, and it was left to the board sailors to prove their ability in trying conditions. Germany's Axel Ohm carving round the inside mark. Durbin's Tim Close following. Eric Maritana from Austria. Springbok Wayne Roberts losing it. But the heat belongs to Axel Ohm. To establish a clear lead from the outset is a decided advantage. And Bjorn Schroeder shows the way. Number one seed Onno Tellier, jibing ahead of the young South African Peter Slate. And in an exciting finish, it's Onno Tellier lollipopping to victory. Durban's top contender Guy Schroeder out-jibing Ivan Khrunov. One of the biggest surprises of the contest was 16-year-old Cameron Bruce from Cape Town. He couldn't get over the winning line fast enough and proved to be more than a match for the superior international competitors. Then it was the chance for the ladies to show their skills. And from the outset, Carla Weber showed her class. In the freshening southeaster, Dana Dawes, the number one seed, got it all together. Into a preliminary final, and Axel Ohm leads from Nevin Sayer, Craig Yester, Cameron Bruce, Bjorn Schroeder, Onno Tellier, and lastly, Olaf von Toll and Rolf Bachschuster. The excellent conditions added to the excitement, and heading for home, here's Nevin Sayer, proving why he's number four in world slalom rankings, as he jumps across the line ahead of Ohm, Yester, and Schroeder. Keeping South Africa's hopes high was schoolboy Cameron Bruce, the only local sailor in a final that was dominated by the internationals.
The internationals are very good. It's a very good experience to sail against them and to compete against them, but it's been tough. It really has been tough. I mean, a lot of the South Africans have suddenly started to realize how good the internationals really are. In the Gunston, a lot of the South Africans were dominating and getting through heats and beating internationals, but I think in the slalom, it's proving that the internationals are superior.
Mastering the elements takes courage, skill, and in particular, experience gained in worldwide competitions.
We have very much competition experience, the World Cup sailors, and for us, we have the right boards, even for the right conditions, so we take smaller boards in strong winds, smaller sails in heavy air, and that's very important to check this out in a good way, not to go out with too big sail, and then it's important that we to start good and so on. It's just that you get such a routine from having a lot of competitions that you get all over, the impression is the performance is better, not at one single point especially, but all over. You count and count and count. That's the big advantage of the World Cup sailors, I think.
You have to check your sail. It's very important to get the right speed. If you're overpowered, if your sail is too big, it doesn't mean that you go faster. You have to take the right sail for the right wind. It's very important. Another thing is I try to sail fast and don't want to jump too much. If you jump high, it looks very nice for the spectators, but you lose a lot of speed and time as well. But compared to last year, big thing happened in South Africa because everybody's using better equipment, better sails and boards, and they learn a lot, these boys here. They drive much better, jump much better, and for sure the winner of the Ganzen is a one South African guy, and it's really good for you.
Board sailing is surely one of the fastest up-and-coming sports in the world today, and the internationals made it look so easy.
When you're getting into it, you don't need that much wind, and you just need a small body of water. You can go to one of the local stores and they can give you a lesson, and it's real easy to learn. You get a big board and a small sail out there and you can learn in a couple hours. Then the more intermediate person goes to spots where there's some surf and maybe a little more wind, and then the advanced will just go for more wind. So the whole sport, it encompasses a lot of different aspects and different levels of sailing.
And drama in one of the final heats. Toby Norman goes down as Guy Schroeder goes through to take the heat. Let's take a closer look at that in slow motion. And what a disappointment for South Africa's Toby Norman as his mast breaks and he's eliminated from the finals. But with some disappointments and plenty of close finishes, the stage is set for an exciting final. And it's the turn of the ladies. Going into their final, Carla Weber, Dana Dawes, Jenny Norman, Marlene Hoekstra, Bridget Gimenez, and Marianne de Jager. America's Carla Weber. Although sealing victory in the final, unfortunately, Carla had to bow to the consistency of Hawaiian Dana Dawes. Her second place was enough to clinch the overall honors. Hawaiian's number one had this to say about the competition.
Along with the conditions and the organization, this is by far the best slalom event I've ever competed in.
Then in near classic conditions, the men's final, with Craig Yester, Cameron Bruce, Axel Ohm, Onno Tellier, Rolf Buchschuster, Dave Daly, Bjorn Schroeder, and Nevin Sayer. Let's pick up the commentary with beach commentator Dan Mangus.
They're off and running here in the finals, and who's it gonna be? Who's gonna carry on? They're really gonna go for it here as they're just getting shot out of the cannon, and the guy's right into a set. And it looks like it's Bjorn Schroeder taking the early lead, Axel Ohm in second. That's Craig Yester way on the outside. Nevin Sayer right in there. Man, this is what it's all about. These guys are really going after it. Look at Bjorn go. Not wasting any time as he comes to the inside mark, and Nevin dropping on the little wave. A really soft spot there as he comes around and hits it cleanly. Bjorn Schroeder rounding first, Nevin Sayer second as they pop through the whitewater. Onno Tellier rounding now in third. Craig Yester in fourth, Rolf Buchschuster in fifth. Axel Ohm now coming fast in sixth, Cameron Bruce in seventh, Dave Daly in eighth. Nevin Sayer now really going after it on the outside, really going after it. Nevin Sayer pulling into the lead. He really wants this victory. And it's Nevin Sayer really putting it down. Bjorn Schroeder in second, Craig Yester third, Onno Tellier in fourth. And who's to say what's going to happen? Oh, and Craig Yester goes down at the mark. It could really matter now what's going on. Craig really saved it, and now he's up and going. And Nevin Sayer now heading to the finish line, dropping into this wave. Almost got it here. It looks like he's got it clinched. And look at it, he just raised his hand in the air. He knows he's got it. Nevin Sayer as he jumps through the line. Woo! Unbelievable, Nevin. He's so happy, he can't believe it. He's jumping for joy. Bjorn Schroeder finishing second.
And an exciting climax to many days of exhausting slalom sailing and over 100 exhilarating heats.
Did you ever think it was possible?
Yeah, I was hoping. We were very close going into that race, and I knew if I won it and Onno was worse than second, I could take it.
And where next?
Well, I'm going to the Bahamas for another contest.
But before the Bahamas, the prize giving. Third in the ladies, South Africa's Marlene Hoekstra. Second, the American Carla Weber. And first, the lady that lost only once in 20 heats, the number one seed, the popular Hawaiian Dana Dawes. The men, third place went to Axel Ohm from Germany.
second to the number one seed and defending champion, the Dutch Onno Tellier. Finally, the honors and 3,500 rand went to the fourth-ranked slalom sailor in the world, America's Nevin Sayer, who had a special word of thanks.
But I'd also really like to thank BASA. They held this competition in the spirit of bringing people together all over the world. And I'd just like to say I'd like to see that spirit continued here at Bloemfontein, here at Cape Town, here in South Africa, and all over the world.
And the young South African Cameron Bruce took sixth place in this exciting Golf GTI Grand Prix.